Hello friends, welcome to another episode by Engineering Today, and we're back with some latest space updates for you. First, we'll start with the completion of Starship's orbital launch pad, which is now the main goal of SpaceX. Second, Musk shows the complex interior of Starship's Super Heavy booster. Lastly, we talk about Bezos' masterstroke. Let's move to our first update. SpaceX now seems to put more focus on completion of Starship's orbital-grade launch pad, which is a great effort from SpaceX as they're on their way to orbital launch. It is for the first time in SpaceX's history that their Texas facility is seeing such a great deal of work. In terms of SpaceX's rocket launch facilities, this site is much ahead of SpaceX's other launch facilities. Every piece of equipment present here is of much bigger size to support the giant rocket. From their earlier expertise and experience earned from building the suborbital launch pads, SpaceX took heed in building the orbital-grade launch pad. SpaceX has to face a lot of hurdles in building the pad, and that too in mere lapse of time. SpaceX has started the construction of the orbital launch site in the beginning of this year, and by the end of July 2021, they're almost nearing completion. SpaceX made their process much faster, and they've got good results. According to a report, the 28th of July 2021 will become the most work full day in SpaceX's history. Now it's time to see what SpaceX has done on their busiest day of the year. At 5 a.m. Central Daylight Time, SpaceX teams carried out the installation of the 9th prefabricated section of Starship's orbital launch tower. With this final section being added, SpaceX effectively completed the vertical structural part. The tower now stands to a height of 145 meters. According to some reports, it is expected that SpaceX will install a lightning rod atop the tower. This rod will further increase the calculative height by nearly 10 meters. As stated earlier, this launch tower will feature an elevator installed with several large robotic arms on its exterior for manipulating starships and Super Heavy boosters. After completion of 9th section installation, the chances of having this elevator become more probable. Side by side, SpaceX carried out some more important tasks. Boca Chica nearly saw a rush of a fleet of self-propelled modular transporters. SpaceX brought in two major components for the orbital launch site. One of them is the most awaited orbital launch table, and the second one is SpaceX's custom-built steel tank for the ground support equipment. SpaceX started assembly work on the launch table nearly 6 months ago. Upon completion, SpaceX has now transported it to the launch site. It's also custom-built by SpaceX. SpaceX has to give some prolonged type to it, as it's going to support the strongest rocket of the world. As per some source reports, this new launch table is capable of withstanding nearly 500 metric tons of weight, which is approximately the same weight as a fueled Starship and Super Heavy. The most striking part of this launch table is that it's not only going to bear the weight of a fueled Starship system, but also to withstand the tremendous thrust of the furious 33 Raptor engines of the booster. It will also hold back the booster during static fires and secure the full Starship system during fueling before static fire or launch. Now, talking about the tank, it was reported much earlier that SpaceX is building tanks for the ground support equipment from the same steel rings they're using for building Starships and Super Heavy. This helped SpaceX to save much of the tank production cost. In April 2021, SpaceX installed two custom-built tanks at the launch site. After those activities were not seen regarding custom-built tanks, only works on tank shells used to insulate cryogenic storage tanks were carried out. SpaceX has also transferred a water tank to the orbital launch site. Now, after 3 months from the earlier custom tank transportation, SpaceX now added one more custom-built tank to the orbital pad tank farm. It happens to be the fifth tank delivery to the tank farm. According to a report on the 27th of July, three Raptor engines were delivered to the Starbase. Following that, a fourth Raptor engine was also delivered to the Texas facility. Some further reports say that SpaceX has recently completed assembly of the 100th fully assembled Raptor engine at their Raptor engine factory. Let's move to our next update. On the 30th of July, Musk revealed the complex interior of the booster in a photo posted on Twitter. Musk wrote on the tweet, "Completing feed system for 29 Raptor rocket engines on Super Heavy booster." Putting a look on the picture, it seems like a complex mixture of huge metal tubes. According to a report, the photo shows the engine section of the booster. But this section is yet to be proven for flight, and its design still relies on the success of Booster 3. A point worth noting is that though Super Heavy is much larger, even the Starship vehicle itself, and also comprises a large number of engines, yet it's much less complex than the Starship vehicle for some technical reasons. These are: Starship comprises movable flaps, numerous thrusters for aerodynamic control, and two different types of Raptors, sea-level and vacuum-optimized, and also complex interior for future cargo and crew versions. On the other hand, the booster has mainly large troops of engines and complex machinery to fuel them and grid fins. But it's also not easy. From Musk's tweet, we get further confirmation that in orbital flight, the booster will have 29 engines. Super Heavy has much more capacity to bear the huge pressure of tons of cryogenic fuels and liftoff thrust. As known, the 29 Raptor engines will produce more than 5,500 metric tons of thrust. Moreover, it will have to face the harsh atmospheric reentry. So the thrust section should have to be very powerful. Some reports say that the 29 Raptors will gobble up nearly 17 metric tons of fuel. According to some recent reports, the engine section will have plumbing running over large distances. Regarding the V2.0 Raptor engines, Musk has recently tweeted on the 29th of July that the Raptor V2.0 is a major improvement in simplification, while also increasing thrust from about 185 tons to 230 tons. Long-term goal is engine cost below 1,000 per ton of thrust. From Musk's tweet, it seems that the second-generation Raptor engines will be less complex with greater output. Now it's for us to see how SpaceX brings out Super Heavy successfully. Let's move to today's last update. On the 26th of July, 2021, Jeff Bezos, founder of Blue Origin, gave an open letter to NASA Administrator Bill Nelson. In the letter, Bezos said that Blue Origin would waive up to $2 billion in payments, and they will also pay for a demonstration mission. Bezos also stated that waiver of payments will cover the present and upcoming two fiscal years. In April, NASA had earlier awarded a $2.9 billion HLS contract only to SpaceX, after SpaceX revised their price plans. Then in May, NASA was forced to suspend the contract as Bezos' company filed a protest against the awarded contract. They held it as unfair. Constant clashes have been going on, while recently the House Appropriations Committee passed a spending bill. The lunar lander got only $150 million more than NASA had earlier asked for, which is much less comparable to the additional $5.4 billion needed to include another competitor. Bezos now gave his masterstroke. Bezos wrote, "Blue Origin was not offered the same opportunity of revising price plans. That was a mistake. It was unusual and it was a missed opportunity. But it is not too late to remedy. We stand ready to help NASA moderate its technical risks and solve its budgetary constraints and put the Artemis program back on a more competitive, credible, and sustainable path. This offer is not a deferral, but is an outright and permanent waiver of those payments. This offer provides time for government appropriation actions to catch up." The letter states, Blue Origin will also fund a Pathfinder mission to low Earth orbit of the lunar descent element to further retire development and schedule risks. NASA's Artemis program required an uncrewed lunar landing demonstration from launch providers. This step from Blue Origin will give an additional demonstration to NASA without any payment from them. With this, Blue Origin's plans may seem relatively cheaper to NASA.
Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting.
and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.